Okay, so today we're going to start making a native Arabian horse halter. We're going to start with the tassels. Tassels can be very time consuming depending upon how many you need. I figure I'll probably do 16. It's probably more than I need, but I'm going to do about 16. So I'll show you what I have here. This is just a piece of cardboard, pretty good sturdy cardboard. Found it in the insert on something. Whatever it was, I don't remember. But anyways, about every half inch, I have these lines both ways to create a grid. And at this end over here, I've got a little slit that I've cut, and that is to hold on to the yarn end, all right? I mean, you can use yarn. I'm gonna use embroidery thread. Now I'm gonna try and use different colors, make this kind of like a scrap piece. This is leftovers from other projects, so. What I'll do is, they're just going to be kind of like a variegated type of tassel. And don't need too many. I'm going to do two wraps of this blue. And you can just pick any one of these. Put the, let's see here, I'm just putting the thread into there. So it'll hold it. And then I'll go ahead and do just one wrap along that line. All right. Now, how many wraps to do is going to be how thick do you want. And, oh, by the way, I cut that end right there, so put the rest of the side. How many wraps you do is how thick do you want your tassels to be. Native tassels are not incredibly thick. They're not like pom-poms, all right? Some of them are pretty sleek and thin, slender. And this is from pictures of actual native halters, real halters that I've seen in my research. So I'll go ahead and take this light blue, and I'll do a wrap of that. And then I'll do another shade of blue. Find the end. Do a wrap of that. And then I've got another. Two more shades. This here is actually three strands. It was left over from a model horse project, Arabian project I did, so this is about all I have left. It's a good use for it, so you don't throw it away. And it's only a triple strand, but I'll go ahead and do a wrap of that. And then this is going to be the base color. It's a very dark navy blue. That'll be the base color of my final halter, so I'll go ahead and put a wrap of that just so that it helps to blend the colors all together, right? All right, so once I have that, now it's a matter of sectioning these off. So since I already have a triple, I already have this piece here, right? And I need some single strands, and these will like the where the tassel is going to bend in half. I'll show you how that works. So now I'm going to go by what is the length of my tassel. Now most of this from here over is just going to be, you know, trash because it's excess. I like to make them long and then cut them to length because it's always easier to go a little bit long and cut it to size than it is to find out they're too short. And if they're too short, it's hard to work with them. So I'm going to go every other line. See right there, it's on the line. And I'm going to double knot that just to keep it secure. Triple knot if you want. You just want it nice and tight so that the strands don't fall off when you're working it. All right. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that every other, all the way down. I usually leave one will end up short and one will be long because you'll need to be able to put a needle on one of these. So I'll go ahead and make one short, one long. And then every other. So my next one's going to be here. And rather than make you watch me tie knots, I'm going to go ahead and cut some of this out. Okay, so now that I've done the knot every other line on this side of the card, I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to do the same thing on this side, okay? And again, you don't need to. Okay, so now if you see, I've got every other has got the tie, and on the other side, every other has the tie. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start cutting the tassels. Don't take it off the card yet. We can go ahead and start here. Smash it down so the other side stays put. This could be the trickiest part. So I'm going to go ahead and the line in between is where I'm going to cut for my tassels. See that? Alright, so using my tassels, and I'll just again use that the lines. It's a little bit stretched, so I'm going to stretch it so that I'm going to make sure I don't cut those. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and. Alright, so I'll just do that all the way around to the end. Alright, so down here where we did the little cut in the cardboard, you can just pull that, right? The other end, this is hard to show and do at the same time, but pull it tight, and then you're going to cut it right, I mean, you can cut it right here, right, or you can cut it this way, and then that'll be another one that needs to be trimmed up excessively. So now I'm going to be really careful when I flip this over to keep this on that line, right, so I can continue to see where I'm going to cut, and I'm going to cut again the line in between. Cut there, and then this last one can just be pulled off. So now you have all these almost tassels, right? It's the beginnings of a tassel. So what I do for these is we have to wrap them. And native wrap is, you know, they're not incredibly wealthy, and what they do have is goats, and they have thread because they spin their own goat hair and sheep hair. So they would cap it by using a thread wrap or a yarn wrap. So I'm going to pick a color. I like using something that's contrasty to the halter. So if my halter is this color, I would use like this color, or maybe a red, right? So we'll just go ahead and I'm going to cut. This is, you know, embroidery thread, 6 strands. So I'm going to just cut a length. It doesn't matter. It's something workable. I think this is about 6 inches long. I'm going to take out a thread, right? One single thread. So find that thread and then pull. And it's easier to do this on shorter lengths than long lengths. So that's why I kind of like I cut them. So I'll go ahead and take one of these. And I'm going to pull this so it's more centered, right? As centered as I can. And then the longer thread, I'm going to pull up and I'm going to hold like right on the knot. And the shorter thread from the tie strand, I'm going to put that into the tassel, right? So your tassel will be about that. So you're going to hold that in place. It'll be about that long. For this thread here, we're going to put a slip knot. And make sure the slip is on the long end, not the short end, right? You might have to practice that if you've never practiced slip knots, but there's your slip knot. So we have our 2 pieces for assembly, right? Got our tassel making and our thread for the wrap on the top. So I'm going to hold it and put the slip knot like that, okay? Now, you have a long piece and a short piece, so I like to put the short piece in with the rest of the tassel, or you could pull it up top. It's about the same color, so, but that's extra, so we'll just probably work it down there. Now, up here is where we're going to do, and you see it's a really teeny tiny, I didn't even know what the measurement there, it's in millimeters, maybe, you know, 3 at the most, and I'm going to take glue, and I'm going to go ahead and put that here. And it's nice to put it all the way around so the wrap stays in place all the way around. And then we'll go ahead and start the wrap, and you're going to have to put them right next to each other. And this can take a little bit of practice, but after you make about 500 of these, it gets easier. And I made quite a few of these for my Arabian horse costume book, which explains how to make bridles and native saddles and arena style. So it's going all the way around. Helps to have a magnifying glass when you get to a certain age, but you're trying to make sure the entire top is wrapped, okay? And then just kind of squeeze it and let the glue dry, okay? So I'm not gonna do anything with this. I'm gonna give it, you know, minutes instead of regular seconds. We'll give it minutes to totally dry, but you can see right now we're almost there, right? And then I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to do one of these where there's the excess, right? So it's gonna be similar. You're just gonna, I like to cut it first, right? So fold it over, find out what the length of the other side is, and then use that yarn to determine where to cut. Okay, so some people don't like the look of this one here. See how it's, you can tell it's multiple strands, right? Not quite miniature, they're a little bit out of size. So they prefer this poofy look where it looks like there's more threads, right? So you can do this. What you wanna do, and I'm gonna show you, this is a tool, you find, it's a pottery tool, right? Used for making, using, I don't know, things in clay, sculptures and things. So I find this is one of my most used tools for a lot of things. But the point is here, you're gonna take the tip of that and you're going to get into the twist of the threads. And each of these threads has a little twist. I got a good one here. Let's see if I can show it. Let's see if I can actually show you one thread what I'm doing. So I'm gonna try and find and push open. See how that thread is, that one or two threads is now looks like it's more, right? And you do that to all of them. And if you've got really good eyes, it's easier. And you just keep marking at it. Oops. And yes, sometimes you can accidentally pull it out of the, so you gotta hold it really tight up here on the thing. And try not to get it under your fingernails. And then once you're done, go ahead and be careful to only trim off that excess at the bottom. Okay? And there you go. You have a poofy tassel. Okay, so we finished the tassels, and now we're going to work on the headstall for the model we're choosing. And I think you guys probably recognize this model, kind of pretty. I love the white ones. I think white's my favorite color. What I'm going to do is we'll need a base for the headstall, and so it's kind of nice to know about how, you know, big you're going to make it. I would go lip to lip plus a quarter inch, and so that'll tell me how long my braid's going to be. And put that. This is just this is a corrugated ribbon, not suitable for like halters or anything, but it is suitable for like Arabian horse costume projects. So we're going to pretty much put this aside. It'll probably be shorter when I'm done, but at least I've got an idea of the minimum size of my braid. Now you can take whatever your base color is, And I picked this dark blue as my base color. This is left over from another project, so it was already cut. But you're going to want at least three times this to make sure you have enough to go one time. So pretty much three times, and then you need three of three times, okay, because we're going to, so we do that, and then the way I measured it, and you kind of see it here, hopefully you can see it here. So we have the head stall length, and this is about three lengths of the finished project, and then I tripled it, and I've got a knot on it, all right, and every little girl learns how to braid, so I'm not going to really do a lot on how to braid, but you'll want to anchor the braid on something. I have this anvil. It's nice and heavy, so it won't move when I'm pulling, and then I just use this little twist tie here, and what I'll do is maybe make a loop. So I've got actually two knots that creates a loop. These are going to be cut away anyways. This is just for starting it, and then go ahead and put my twist tie through it on my rubber band, so I got a little bit of pull or stretch on it. I find easier if it's got a little stretch that I can braid, and then, you know, separate the strands and start braiding. Now what we're gonna do is gonna take our little piece of for the headband, and we're going to glue this probably from here to here, not all the way to the end. I would keep 3/4 inch, maybe 1/2 inch at the least, unglued. All right, so we're going to take glue. It doesn't have to be a lot. White glue usually spreads pretty good. And then make sure these are flat, right? And oops, I went too far on the side. Don't do that. All right, so we're gonna put this one on this side, and make sure you have extra going over, and then we'll loop, make sure you've got extra going over, right, and then flat, make sure it's flat, so it's side by side all the way along the base ribbon. Now if you notice, the base ribbon is not as wide as the two pieces next to each other, and that's on purpose, because you don't really want to see that. But if there's any gaps, because it's similar to the same color, nobody's really going to see it. All right, so we'll pull this away. So pull that away. I don't really want that on my... All right, so I've got about 1/2 inch on both sides. It's not glued, so go ahead and let that like set up. And that's going to be the basis of your headband. So what they do with these is the endings actually become tassels, all right, and they kind of just stick straight out. So once it's glued, you're going to want to get your exact fit. So let's see if I can, all right, and we're going to put rings. Now I'm working in gold, because I don't get to very often, and I actually have a lot of gold. So we're going to, your nose band is going to be right about here, right? It's not down here by the nose. Even though it's called nose band, it's going to be up here, okay? And so we want to make sure our rings, and these are just, oh, by the way, these are 6 millimeter. Some people do smaller, and that's fine. I'm doing 6 millimeter because it's easier to see on camera. Okay, so here's my 6 millimeter ring. I'm gonna go ahead and glue this on, right, because it's a halter. We're gonna put a nose band on here and then a chain underneath. So we'll start with gluing. There. And if you've seen any of my other videos, you know that when I'm working with a ribbon, because it just takes longer to set up, I have these clothespins, right? And that'll just hold it. Go ahead and let that dry, because I need to get a good fit on the other side. Okay, so took the clip off dry enough, you know, it's not gonna open up. And we want to make sure that our nose strap, nose band, and it's gonna be a decorative one, is in the right place, right? So that will do that, and then we'll flip it over. This model, this is one of the things performance shows don't like about some of the models that come out, is sometimes they don't have a clean brow band here. She's got just a little bit there that's going to make this an interesting fit. I can see my fingers aren't in the way. And so we want to make sure this other one, I'm going to finger press it. I think that's a little bit too long. A little bit more off, because I want my nose band to be right about there, right? So I'm going to go ahead and finger press. Put the beauty aside. And then get that ring on there. And you can trim that if you want. I'm just going to go ahead and glue it. I don't like to glue close to the ring. You'll see that a lot of times I'm a little bit away from it. I'm making that camera move. I think I prefer that it isn't right to it. I think the tack moves more freely if you don't glue right to the rings. Okay, so there's that. All right, so we're going to put that aside and let that dry. All right, so now it's dry, right? It's ready to be used. So go ahead and flip that over. Now, if you've seen Native Arabian halters, you'll know that the headband goes past, the tassels go past the mouth, all right? So this is about the right length that we want. We'll lose a little bit, but we can always, if we had to, we could just put tassels on there with some beads. I'm just going to do turn these into actual tassels, doing tassel wrap, all right? So I'll show you how we do that. Don't fall over, lady. Okay. I think that's a guy. All right, so we're going to go ahead and cut that. And then very carefully, we'll go ahead and undo these. It's shadows. Where are my shadows? Alright, so just very carefully. I don't want to rip through three, but I'm just going to do two here. Okay, so these are going to turn into tassels. And showed you tassel wrap, right? So I'm going to use three different wraps. And so I just short pieces, right? I'm going to do this on both sides, but I'll just show you the one side and then show you what it's like when it's done. Okay, so we're going to do, just like with tassels, we're going to do a wrap. So make your slip knot and put your threads in there. Okay, here's your trick if they get curly. A little bit of moisture on your finger, and that helps. And then when it dries, it's nobody will ever know you spit on it. Okay. oh, and also doesn't bother the white glue, which is important. So I'm going to get my wrap as close there as I can. And unlike my tassels, I'm going to work in this direction instead of back. So I'm going to put the glue here, and it's not that much, just the amount you're going to wrap. And this can get a little bit crazy, but we need to wrap And sometimes the yarn cooperates, and sometimes it doesn't. But that time it did. Okay. So that's good. All right. See? And I really want to make sure I can go down the back. And then I'll go ahead and let that dry. And then I'm going to pick another color. I'm going to go ahead and do a kind of like medium blue. This is in my tassel, so it's not, it's part of the color palette. And just cut myself a strip of it. And that's because it's easier to break apart a small length of embroidery thread than a long length. And that was good. All right, I'll try this one. I'll pull that out, and it's going to be basically the same thing. And we'll go ahead and put the slip knot on first. Good for me. There you are. Good. Be good for me. Alright, nice and tight. And then we'll do glue on both sides. And we'll wrap it. And yeah, I'm wrapping both strands. Trying to get them like right next to each other. So that's my second color. And then my third color is another light blue. Again, this was in my tassel. And I just want about 6 inches of it. This is from other projects. Never one all by itself. Okay, so we're going to take about, I don't know, I guess that's about 4 inches if you're wondering. So about 4 inches. And then grab a strand. This stuff just is so bent, it's gonna be harder to work with. All right. And then one more time. In this case here, I'm just going to go ahead and cut this excess because it's pretty much on there now. And I can use that. There's still enough left. I can use it for the other side. I'll trim that a little bit. All right. I guess it's done. And I didn't get all the way. Gonna do this so I didn't get this thread close enough, so I'm just gonna start the wrap back of where the slip knot was and then bring it around. Alright, so there's your wrap. That's a little bit more glue than I needed, but that's alright. So now I'm going to do the same thing on this other side, and then
probably have to trim that just a little bit, but there's your tassel. All right, so the ring's right behind it. Okay, see that? All right, let me do the other side, and we'll get going. Almost finished, right? Last wrap on the other side, and I'm looking at the back side. And so just to keep them together, I'm going to go ahead and do a wrap between or around the ends on both sides, okay? And this will just keep it, you know, straightforward, and so they don't, you know, separate and look weird. So we're just going to do like that. And I didn't get them exactly the same, so I wasn't really paying as much attention as I should have been. But there you go. There, it was just like a single wrap and holds it together. Okay, so one of the things on this other side here is just to make it easier, I'm going to go ahead and cut off the excess here, longer than it needs to be, but I get to cut off all those knots. So now see how it's free, and using the, you know, 1/3, 3, or, you know, length times 3 and then 3 strands, you don't have a lot of waste, okay? And usually you have a little bit extra, but, you know, that's fine. It's better to have a little extra than not enough, so... So we say you can always cut it shorter, but you can't stretch it once it's cut. So I'm going to go ahead and do to this side what I did to the other side. So won't make you watch it a second time, but that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so here's the headstall with the ends wrapped. And so now we're going to, you know, trim it up a little bit. I'm going to get my rings so that they match. And I'm going to go ahead and use my good scissors, right? And I'm gonna go across. I usually have to get rid of a little bit of that, like that. All right. And then, so we've got the tassels on the end. Now, this is one of many ways I've seen native halters done, okay? There's more than one way. So I know that what we see a lot in the model horse ring is the two tassels. So usually it's the wrap, and then you add tassels with beads to the end. I'm not going to do that with this one because I showed that in my book. This one here, I'm just going to show, you know, the ending tassels. So this is a halter, not a bridle, which is, this is what they would wear when you take them out of the stall to, you know, go ahead and brush them down. And so it's going to be different. It's an everyday thing, not a show thing, right? And our halters are really lovely, simple. They are. Okay. And it's trying to make sure that they're individual. They don't look like they came from a... So, there we go. And that's your headstall. So there you go, that's your headstall, and now we're ready to move on to the noseband. Okay, so we're back. I'm going to go ahead and take this chain, and I'm going to get my pliers, and I'm going to open my jump ring just enough. See, it's open just enough to put the chain in. Okay. And then I'll go ahead and close it up. Make sure you close it all the way, because otherwise the chain will get through that. Okay. So once I have one side done, now I need to measure it to my model. All right. People see me do this all the time. I put it on the model. Okay, the reason why I do that is we say, you know, this is a traditional scale. But this model's head is different from
size from the other ones. So just making it for this doesn't necessarily mean it's going to fit all of them. So if I want a good fit, I need to fit it to the model I'm going to put it on, right? So I'm going to try and, it's hard to do this direction, but usually I have it standing up. I can't do that with my camera, so I want to try doing this so you can see it while he's lying down. So I'm fitting the halter, finger, you know, just kind of dry fitting, and making sure that my tassels stick out right, same place. And it's, make sure I don't do the nose thing too short. Okay, so that's going to be about right. All right, I want to make sure that this isn't, if the nose band is too short, it'll pull it up into the horse's eye. And there's not, with that forelock there, it's already going to be a crazy fit. So I'm going to make it a little bit longer just to accommodate some of the bumps and stuff around here. But what I've figured now is I can see where I want to clip that, all right? I've already pulled it tight over here, and I've fit it this side to where I want it. So I'm just going to go ahead and clip one link past where I'm going to attach to the ring. So you can see that. So here's the ring, and it's going to attach to that, right? So I'm going to, I want to attach it to this one right here, so I am going to cut the one right after it, all right? Remember that, cut the one right after it. And that would mean cutting the one that my little needle's in. Okay, I'm just cutting that one right there. See that? And I'm going to cut that. I mean, you don't have to. If you want to, you can bust the link. Sometimes they're soldered and you can't. All right, so I have now done that. Ooh, be careful. All right, so now I'm going to attach that to the other side. So I will open up my jump ring. My jump ring. And it's very important you don't have any twists. This has to lay flat. So make sure that it's flat and then thread it on to the jump ring. Okay? And that way there's no, do I have any twists? If I pull that, what's that kink? I don't like that kink. Okay. Can I do that again? I don't like that kink in there. All right, so I'm going to pull it. So now I'm going to turn that. There we go. I think that'll do it. So that it's on that last one. Close this up and see if I did it right. So now if I put it on him and I pull it, it will. See how it lays flat all the way? That's very important. Okay, I don't know if it's even or odd. Links depends upon the gauge of the chain, but there you go. There's the noseband, and this is what you would put your probably start right about there, and you could just go ahead and put the shark's teeth or coins. That's another thing they did. Either if it's not the gold shark's teeth, it's the coins, or sometimes there's a mishmash of different charms that are designed to protect the horse. That's what the charms are really for. So now we need to do the chain that is under, but we need to determine how long this is going to be. So it's going to be under the horse's chin, right? So see if you can see this. So it's going to be through, make sure I got this right, don't want to do it wrong. Okay, so it's going to be through
the loop on the outside, under the horse's chin, through the loop on the inside, alright, so the nose will go into where that hole is, right, this hole right here, and we have to determine how long do I want this chain to be. They kind of like it elegantly long, but you can make it whatever looks about right for your animal. I don't want to get it, I'll stick my finger in there to be his nose, and then I'll stick my pinky, because that's my smallest finger, right? And then I can kind of pull it, and I want it to be, right about here, right? And then I'll add some tassels and stuff, but that's about how long I want it. So I'll go ahead and trim it. Now, you can use another jump ring to attach both of these ends to. And that's probably is the least expensive way to do it. I happen to have what came with same model horse hardware supplier is these lead rope. These are kind of cool. These lead rope fittings, right? And it's one or the other. I'm going to use the smaller one. And so I'm going to go ahead and put one end on either side of the hole, okay? And one thing, if you know about these fittings, is that you do have to clean them. And this one hasn't been cleaned yet, so just quickly show you. Clip off just a little bit of it. And then just to get the rough edge off, okay, so that's pretty much what it takes to clean their buckles and everything else. It's not a lot of work. So let's go ahead and get a little crazy, because we're going to have to find the opening. I think I'm going to use two pliers because it's so tiny. You could put jump rings, you know, like a 3mm jump ring would probably be also would work. I need to find this opening. So, is that that one? That's the one. Almost even got it. Okay, gonna open it. Gonna put the thing in there. Gonna carefully close it. Closing is important, because if you don't close it right, that'll go all the way through. So, got that. Okay. Now, before we do the other side, make sure it's threaded right. Because it came unthreaded. And then we want to make sure we get the twists out. We don't want any twists. So, let's see if we can get the twists out. Good. And then go ahead and so that's the one with you. It's the other side. And close it up. All right, so slip that over. Plenty of room. Plenty of room to get the nose in. Pulse tight. Okay. Now, get to the leader open in a minute. What I am going to do, though, is talk about the uniqueness of the Arabian horse halter. They have always have a throat latch. Always have a throat latch. Never a brow bound, always a throat latch. Totally different from anything you find in the U.S., right? Or Western world, if you want. So, we're going to need to create a throat latch. And you can braid a single strand. You can leave it the way it is. But basically, it's just something that is attached. And you can glue it if you want. I'm going to glue it because it's faster. You can create little loops or whatever. But I'm going to go ahead and take just an unbraided strand. And I'm going to go from about there to over here. This is just a quick fix, right? You can, you know, like I said, braid your own. But I'm just going to put that. Do that right along the edge here. The trick is for it to be even, right? And so that's about right. This is not quite as that's about right. This side, you can use just a little bit more. And this white glue I use, it dries clear, okay? So the only thing I worry about is when it attaches to my skin, I get this. I mean, didn't everybody do that in school? You spread the glue all over your hand, they peel it off. Yeah, that's what it does. but it's dry, it can be peeled away. Right, simple. Just kind of even want to make sure that it doesn't come apart. There you go. All right, so that will suffice as your throat latch threads. Okay, long enough. These are way too long, but I have pre-cut pieces, so. You can, these were about 10 inches long, pre-cut from a different project, embroidery project I never finished. So, using that up. And it's not really meant to be seen, so they're usually not that, what you call, decorative. Blends in. What they do, though, is they have a way to close it, right, and make it tighter. So, I'm just going to use a gold bead, right? Kind of like a bolo tie works. So we're going to take these. I'm going to kind of put a little spit on them. So they'll stick together. And then put them through my little gold bead. And then make them probably straight like that. They're about the same. And this, it would be open position, all right? So at open position, I am going to create a knot. And that will keep my bead. I mean, you could see people making these for their horses, right? You don't have a lot, but you might have a little bit of hardware and you got a bunch of horses and you hand make these so that your horses have halters, right? And what you do have is the goats and sheep, and you weave, and you, you know, whatever found materials you have. So they would use probably a handmade bead, but because I'm using gold, it's a kind of an extravagant. So this is a richer peasant than the rest of them, right? So now I have an open position, and then when it's on the horse, you can close the daddles. We're going to do something here. This is going to be attached, permanently attached on this. So we have to decide, do I want to make it match everything else, right? So I'm going to do a multicolored braid. I'll pick colors. Obviously, I have all of this pre-cut dark blue that I'm trying to use, so we'll use that. So I'll go ahead and do the other blue that I had. It was a light blue. Right. And then I'm going to do the last of this medium blue, so almost none left. So that's perfect. You know, it's a great way to use up projects, you know, supplies from other projects. It's just do something similar. Okay. So now I've got three strands. And because it's going to be permanent, I'm just going to start the braid right in here, right? And then, so I'm going to get my anvil, and this time I'm going to use it just to keep this from moving. I got my anvil up there, see, and then I've got my, still learn how to do this, okay, so, alright, so I've got my anvil, see, put it on top, right, and try not to smash it too much, and then I've got my strands here that are attached to that. And it's going to be fun. All right, I'm going to take the light blue on this side, and I want to pair it with like a dark blue on this side. And also, let's see, we'll do, make sure the light blue, the dark blue on that side, and then medium blue. All right, so and then medium blue. Let's do medium blue with dark blue. And now I've got my three strands, and that's the color combination. And we're just gonna go ahead and braid. And then for the final ending on the braid, because I don't like big knots, we're going to do what I showed you before, around and then through. Okay. The strands will cooperate. There we go. And then if we do that just right, just like cinching up a horse, and all three strands, or all six strands, will lay flat, and it's a really tiny knot, right? So we'll go ahead and cut it about tassel length, because that's almost a tassel, right? And that is pretty much done. Now it's going to be finished work from here. Okay, so now it's time to do finishings. This is tassels and beads and whatever it is that you want to use to decorate, finalize the decoration. And I mean, the more that you do, obviously, the more amazing it's going to look. sometimes there are sheiks who say that you never want to cover up a beautiful horse, right? You don't want to detract from the beauty of the horse. So they don't do a lot. They would rather that the horse shine than the actual halter. Now, one of the things I noticed when I had it up is that this is rather long. So what I'm going to do, I don't need all of this. I'm just going to glue the end on this knot. I'm going to glue this knot because I don't want it to come undone, right? And with white glue, you can just kind of mush it like that. Okay. And then I'm going to put another knot a little bit further up, probably about there, about an inch up from there, and make that my, I made this, the opening there way too big. So I'm going to get another knot about an inch up. I'll still be able to get it onto the horse, but it'll be a little bit better scale. So see that? It's about an inch. Okay. And now that the glue is dry, I'm going to just cut this off. I don't need this. All right. So that would actually be a basic ending for your throat latch. So from here, we'll talk about endings. And all by itself, this is still a beautiful halter, right? And it's still acceptable. It's still a Bedouin style native halter. But when we're trying to show off as well. You might see if anybody makes some miniature cowrie beads. They would be very tiny, but I've seen them in, you know, just rows of two little cowrie made beads out of sculpey clay. I make my own cowrie beads. Yes, I do make my own cowrie beads. I show how to do it in my book. And these are what they look like. So I made these out of sculpey. And this was just, I made sets, and this was leftovers from the sets that I didn't use. I still have some left. I should probably put them up for sale because I just don't do Arabian horses like I used to. After I did my book, I think I was done. I made all those I wanted to make. But anyways, so these are also called cowrie beads, and they're called that because these little white things here, these are cowries. Cowries are a particular type of shell that they sew into felt is what it is. So this bases are supposed to be felt, to be fabric. And then depending upon how elaborate they want to make them, they can also put beads, handmade beads. So think of it that way. It's felt and then beads sewn onto the felt, right? So I'm going to use these because I have them. And because it is traditional native. Now, I've got plenty of room for a bunch of them, but I'm just going to do maybe five on either side. And I'm just going to use regular white glue. Lay this flat. All right. And I'm going to put a healthy dot of glue every place that I want to carry. Too much, we can do that. And then 3, 4, 5. And that one didn't. This is unusual for just string like that. So I'll just pick the red one there, the green one, there's only one yellow one. Well, I'll do that yellow one. Okay. Yellow one there. Since I got them, I'll just do another.
All right, because usually it's going to be, it's going to say 5, but it's turning out to be 4, isn't it? All right, and even these feel like they're huge compared to this, right? But that's, well, I can't make them any smaller. Okay, and then I'm going to do the same for the other side. And I'm going to use the pattern, or I'm going to, for comparison, I'm going to put them right next to each other, right? To make sure I get them at approximately the same distance. So we'll go right there. The green. Do the yellow. Don't be difficult. Being difficult. And then another red. What it's going to look like with the beads on it. Adds a lot of color, right? And that's very traditional looking. Okay, so now we're at the final stage. We're going to go and put our tassels on, all right? So first of all, you need beads. I picked these 3. Gold has been part of the theme, again, pushing it a little for a native, but we're doing a rich Bedouin, right? And then I like these little peacock beads. They kind of change color. That'll add just something to it. And then, of course, just traditional blue, all right? So what you'll do is, because I want this to stand out, I'll start with my gold. Make sure you thread a tassel. I should talk about the needle. So the needle needs to be thin enough to go through the center of the beads. But it also needs to be stiff enough that you can go ahead and attach it wherever, right? And then, so you go ahead and you thread your tassel end onto the thread. And then we're gonna do 3 beads. So I'll do gold, I'll do blue, and then I'll do one of the peacock ones. All right, so once I've got my 3 beads, then I'm going to go ahead and decide, well, where am I going to put it? They actually don't put that many tassels. Again, they don't like to cover up the beauty of the horse, but I'm going to basically put one right next to all of these beads that I've already glued on. So put one here, which is going to be hard because there's glue there. Okay. goes on, and then you don't want it too tight because then it won't move. And I see a lot of these where they're so tightly sewn, they're just stiff. All right, so I'm going to just make sure I don't pull too tight, and then I'll go one more time just to secure it, right? Same place as I did before, just so that it goes all the way around once, and then I am going to feed back right through the beads, all 3 beads, come out the end here, because if you don't get, if this breaks, the whole thing falls off, right? So I want to make this as long as possible. This string here, I'm going to keep that as long as possible, the one that's in my needle. So I'm going to just then go through the top of the tassel. And now I've pulled it a little too tight, but loosen it a little bit. And now
if I want to, my final wrap. In this case, it'll work. I'm gonna just see if I can get it to go through one more time from the top. Then I will cut it so that it's the same length as the tassel, right? Nobody will know what I did. Nice and hidden, and it's going to be very secure. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and do four on this side, and I'm going to do four on the other. All right. Okay, so here's the halter with the tassels on the side. And now I counted up my tassels. I made a total of 14. I thought I was making 16, but I only made 14. So I've got six more to decide where I'm going to put. I want to put a couple here on my lead rope. I want them hanging off. They don't really draw attention to this, okay? This is a functional thing. This is the beauty thing. So I know some people would be tempted to just go ahead and add more tassels to the throat latch. I'm not going to overdo tassels at all on this particular one. So again, I'll show you what to do. Go ahead and thread the needle. The hardest part of beading is getting the thread through the eye. That through. Okay, we're going to pick, like we did before, we're going to do a gold and a peacock and then a blue. I'm just going to go ahead and however you want to do this. Wrap it because it's a way to stabilize this rope connection. I'll put it through that side. Thing is, I don't have a lot of this to work with. Go around through the beads, through the top of the tassel. Okay, I'll show you through the beads. I usually go straight through, but it is through the beads and then through the top of the tassel, right like that. Okay, and then pull it. And if it's too tight, it's not going to hang correctly, and you want it to hang. And those beads provide you with the weight that allow that to happen. And then to secure it, I'm just going to make just a little, kind of like a knot, or like a quilter's knot. I'm just going to bring it through one time. See, nobody really even see that. But that's your knot. And then go ahead and cut that. All right, so I'll go ahead and do one more. Here, because I've got them, I'll do another tassel on the other side, and then we'll be done.